गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वी आर सीइंग द पेपर नंबर 6, दैट इज फिश डिसीज मैनेजमेंट. एंड इन दैट फिश डिसीज मैनेजमेंट आवर करंट टॉपिक इज टाइप ऑफ फिश डिसीजेस, दैट इज ऑफ द यूनिट नंबर 2. एंड इन दैट यूनिट नंबर 2 वी आर गोइंग टू सी द अनदर वन इम्पॉर्टेंट फिश डिसीज, दैट इज नोन एज एपिजेटिक Ulcerative syndrome. In short, it is also known as EUS, that is epizootic ulcerative syndrome. So, what is the meaning of epizootic and ulcerative and syndrome? Dear friends, epizootic is nothing but any type of disease which will spread on a large scale among the animal. Among the organism, that type of disease is known as epizootic type of disease. So epizootic is nothing but on a large scale spread of disease on a large scale, that is simply epizootic. And ulcerative is nothing but any type of damage to the tissue of organism is nothing but the ulcerative, where the blood vessels, tissues and cells are damaged by a certain type of pathogen, certain type of infection, and it makes a wound like structure, that is nothing but the ulcer or ulceration. So it is nothing but a damage of tissue and producing a wound into the organism, that is simply the ulcerative or ulceration. Let us see about what is the syndrome. Syndrome is nothing but a group of the symptoms, the characters of particular organism is known as the syndrome. So that means this epizootic ulcerative syndrome is nothing but study of such type of disease which is spread on a large scale and damaging the tissue and cells and skin of the organism, and which is showing a particular group of the symptom, that is simply nothing but epizootic ulcerative syndrome. This epizootic ulcerative syndrome is found into the number of freshwater fishes, brackish water fishes and so on. This EUS, epizootic ulcerative syndrome, is also known as a red spot disease or granulomatosis. Red spot, which is giving the red appearance of that wound, therefore commonly known as red spot disease, as well as it is also known as granulomatosis, where this appearance of granules like structure is forming on the skin, therefore it is known as granulomatosis. So epizootic ulcerative syndrome, as well as red spot disease, as well as granulomatosis, these are the synonyms for such type of disease. The name indicate ulceration, red spot. See that picture. There are picture of, these are the on the your screen, these are picture of the infected fishes. See how a wound is forming on the skin muscle of the fishes. So when it is a heavier at that time, it is become a deeper and deeper. So these are the infection of, the slide is showing the infection of the epizootic ulcerative syndrome. Let us see about the causing organism. As we know that a number of diseases are having a involvement of the pathogen. They are some pathogenic or some are non-pathogenic, and some are a nutritive type of diseases commonly found into the fishes. This epizootic ulcerative syndrome is having particular type of pathogen, and that pathogen is simply nothing but water molds. So this, what is water mold? This water mold is nothing but a fungus-like structure. It is simply a fungus-like structure which is present into the fresh water, marine water, brackish water, as well as such type of the molds are also occurring into the moist soil also. So simply this disease, epizootic ulcerative, is caused by a water molds, and these water molds are having a number of species, and particularly this EUS is formed by a particular species that is known as Aphanomyces invadens. So Aphanomyces invadens is a species of mold, and that is causing red spot disease or ulcerative syndrome. These are the filamentous structure, filamentous like organism, and initially it was included into the fungus group, but now after a detailed classification, that have been placed in a group of diatoms or and the brown algae, and in a group called the it is also called as the Chromista. So nowadays it is placed into the Chromista. So basically it is a fungal like structure. Keep in mind that what are the water molds? Water molds are a filamentous fungus like structure which is causing a heavy damage to the fishes on a large scale. Therefore it is also known as epizootic. Any type of infection spreads into the water body or anywhere at that time, that is known as the epizootic. These water molds, that is Aphanomyces invadens, is generally, or these water molds are generally that are saprotrophic in habit, that are saprotrophic, that means living on dead or decaying organic matter. As we know that in the water bodies, lakes, rivers, reservoirs, number of plants are there, dead bodies, when the animals die, as well as any type of pollution load, organic load is there, that molds will survive on such type of decaying material. The growth of that fungus like filamental growth is taking place on that dead material or organic type of material decaying into the bottom of the ponds. These water molds, this red spot or epizootic ulcerative syndrome, is more dangerous. It is more causative when it has, the habitat has low temperature and heavy rainfall. The area where the temperature is low as well as heavy rainfall is there, like the tropical and subtropical type of waters. So in this tropical and subtropical type of waters, there is a greater chances for development of such type of disease, that is red spot disease. Not only that, when after no doubt when there is a low temperature is there as well as the heavy rainfall is there, but after the heavy rainfall, within a week or within a few couple of days, here the growth of that organism will taking very fast. Therefore not only into the rainy, after finishing the rainy season also, due to such type of the moisture, such type the fungal development occurs, and that is red spot disease. This red spot disease, or that fungus like structure of Aphanomyces invadens, see here, the causing organism of that epizootic ulcerative syndrome is Aphanomyces invadens. This disease more causative at different levels. This I told that heavy rainfall as well as the low temperature, these are stimulating, these are providing a favorable atmosphere, favorable condition for development of that disease in the form of zoospores. So it develops the zoospore disease. Transmission is through the zoospore in fresh water as well as the brackish water, marine water, and when the infected fish will get in contact with the another type of the fishes, at that time there is a greater chances of contamination. So it is contaminated, it is transmitted through the zoospore, and that zoospore is a major cause for the development of fungus structure. When there is a zoospore, it can encyst if it found the suitable type of a host, and if it does not form the suitable type of host, it can survive up to the 19 days also. So when it immediately germinate, it immediately incubate, when it gets a favorable condition or a suitable type of the host, and if it does not get, it will remain active near about 19 days. So let us say about the some important type of the symptoms. I told that the syndrome is nothing but a group of certain particular type of symptoms in particular disease. So these are the symptoms. Syndrome is nothing but simply the symptoms, a group of the symptoms. So we talk about the symptoms generally, or you may call as the basically this disease is called as red spot. Therefore ultimately you can get the idea, it is giving a red spot or over the skin of infected fishes. It can be present over the skin of body, head, also the on the fin also. In early stage, the red spot or small hemorrhage lesions are found. A small red spot, it may be the pinhead like, in very early stage infection started. We can observe by studying the observing the fish and their symptom. Initially a small pinhead like red patch, red spot occur on the skin, and after the you may call as this infection goes to the advanced stage, at that time it have a heavy loss of tissues, of epithelium tissues and cells and muscles of that particular host animal. So in advanced condition, these lesions expand on into the large necrotic, and it forms the open type of ulcer, and this wound, this damage of tissue and cell will go deeper and deeper, and hence the fish will get infected, a heavy infection of that epizootic ulcerative syndrome. I told that it is a fungus like structure, a branched fungus like structure that is simply known as a mycelium, a hyphae. So hyphae is formed, and that mycelium is commonly found on the top of here. The infection, the mycelium is generally found on the top of the ulcerative lesions or the red spot. These lesions can range from, I told that, range from a small pinpoint head into the large hemorrhagic spot. A large spot is there, and during that time you can observe it is having a local type of swelling to that area. Localized area of the skin, body surface will just get a swelling, and many other times the this fish may show the protruding type of scales. Scales are get elevated, and many of the times here the scales, loss of scales may occur, and it starts the erosion of the skin, erosion of the tissue of the skin. And this scales may have within the scale may have a red like structure, and exposure of underlying musculature and ulceration form. So this is a little bit of the symptom of that epizootic ulcerative syndrome. Symptoms are very simple. Firstly, red spots occur. Secondly, when red spot may be of the pinhead, secondly that pinhead red spot may goes up to the large wound like structure, where there is a heavy damage of the tissue and cells of the skin. Besides that, whenever there is a signal of that red spot disease in that particular fish, if the fish is scaly, there may be the elevation of the scales as well as loss of the scale and erosion of the skin is occurring. Let us say about, I am not going to say that it is a life cycle, but it is a pattern of reproduction. Let us see about the how that organism will reproduce. In early stage of infection, that internal organ does not show a severe type of the inflammatory response. Initially, it was very normal, and that internal organs of that fishes does not show any type of inflammatory response. The early stage lesions or spot show a spongiosis, that is a loss of certain type of epithelial cells of the skin. That skin, that muscles, that cells will become a spongy due to the growth and infection of that actinomyces invadens, that is water mold, that is a fungal like structure due to the development and growth of mycelium, or you may call as a hyphae. In early stage, if you treat that fish with a, you may call as a better water quality at that time, there may be the recovery, healing of the, you may call that wound. When water quality is standard, water quality is appropriate, at that time the healing of that wound may occur, and when healing is there, you can see that wound will give, leaving a dark, you may call as scars at the infection site. That means whenever it is a process of recovery, after the recovery of that wound, after the recovery of damage, it leaves a black color type of the mark over the skin of the infected fishes. In advanced stage, lesions expands no doubt and into a large necrotic open type of ulcer form, and deep type of hemorrhagic ulcer is found. So that means here, due to the infection of that actinomyces invadens or water mold or that fungal like structure, there is a degenerative changes are observed into the epidermis as well as the dermis. This, it produces, we are talking about the reproduction, it produces the oomycetes. That oomycetes of mycelium has two spores, forming two spores, a primary spore which are placed at the tip of the sporangium, where it forms a cluster of spores. Oomycetes are there, and that oomycetes are going to form the zoospore, that zoospore of the two type, and that is primary zoospore which is present on the tip of the oogonium and forming a cluster like structure. After forming a cluster like structure, that quickly transfers into the secondary zoospore. The zoosporangium, the sporangium forming the secondary zoospore, which is producing a number of the spores which have a laterally biflagellate structure, and that can swim freely into the water. Two types of zoospores are formed. One is having a rounded oval type, which is having a pair of flagellate like structure, and another one is the, you may call as the kidney shape or bean shape of the spore is forming, and that is having a biflagellate structure to the concave side of that zoospore. So the formation of the zoospore, the primary zoospore as well as the secondary zoospore, and that secondary zoospores are having two types depending upon the position of the flagella. One is a spear type, another one is a bean shape or kidney shape, and in that convex side of that bean shape structure, there is a pair of flagellates are there, a kidney shape structure is there. So later zoospore will get encysted, it will get encapsulated, it will get the encapsulated. So a covering is formed on the zoospore, and it will go to germinate into the few hyphae. After the germination, that single zoospore will give a number of the hyphae, number of eumycotes mycelium or a branch like structure hyphae is for. And when that branch like structure hyphae will get in contact with the new host, at that time again it will start development, producing the primary zoospores, producing the sporangium, primary zoospore, secondary zoospore, and again the flagellate type of zoospore is forming, and that is again responsible for giving a new type of hyphae, giving a new type of hyphae for the new host. If that spores does not form any type of the you may call as the host or substratum, at that time it remain as it is near about up to the 19 days. Let us see about the few important control measures. I am not going to see the details because number of the you may call as the control measures that are similar, a similar content is there. That means near about a broad type of the treatment spectra is there. Number of the chemicals, number of the methods are similar from number of diseases. So this infected and more we know that the precaution is better than the cure. On that basis you isolate that infected fishes away from that pond, away from the aquarium, into the water, into the pond where the water quality is a standard, a good quality of water is there. And due to the good quality of water here, there is a that good quality of water is helping to the healing of that damage, heavy damage of the tissue. That means a quarantine or isolation of infected fishes, it is one of the major type of the precaution. It is a, of course it is a precautionary measure, and by which we can also control such type of infection. And in the same way, it does not have any type of the commercial vaccine, and certain you may call as antibiotics like the clotrimazole is also found. It is also giving a better result for control of that disease, as well as along with the clotrimazole, it is having number of the chemicals you can use, that the chemicals as per the doses described, as per the standard doses you have to apply to the fishes. And treatment of melachite green, of course you have to give the bath of treatment of the melachite green in the ratio of 0.1 mg per liter. You can also treat that infected fishes with a formalin that having dose 25 milligram per liter of the water solution, and captrol up to the 5 ppm. Also you can also the lime 2 kg per 100 meter square of the pond bottom. So several commercial type of the chemicals are there. Number one precautionary measure is quarantine the fish, isolate the fish for better recovery and good quality of water. Similarly, you can also use the clotrimazole, which is also effective, the treatment of melachite green, treatment of formalin, captrol, as well as the lime. These are also useful, as well as the bath of the potassium permanganate at the rate of 5 ppm. Similarly, a bath of the common salt is also useful. 1% of the common salt, that is NaCl, that is edible salt, table salt, is also found a good result over the control of the episodic ulcerative syndrome. Similarly, we can also use a bleaching powder at the rate of 1 ppm into the eumycotes aquarium. And when it is a pond, at that time you have to use near about 5 to 10 kg per hectare of that bleaching powder. So the bleaching powder is also the one of the good option for treatment of that episodic ulcerative syndrome. Some research shows that here increasing the acidity, especially after the flood, because low chloride and alkaline level in water may increase the chances of infection. That means when there is a low chlorides into the water, alkaline level is there, at that time there is a greater chances of infection of that episodic ulcerative syndrome. Besides that, liming of water with the agricultural lime, just I have told already, that is also having good results. So these are the as well as the increasing the concentration of salts into the water, as well as some recent development says that nanoparticles of the silver and zinc oxide. Of course, these are certain new research is there, nanoparticles of the silver as well as the zinc oxide, that are also giving a better results, but study is just yet to complete. So of course, the application of that silver oxide as well as zinc oxide, that is nanoparticles of silver oxide and zinc oxides, that are in a vitro condition, not on a large scale, not on the field. So, but let us hope they will also give a better result. So these are the some of the important control measures of that epizootic ulcerative syndrome or red spot disease or granulomatosis disease, which is forming into the fresh water as well as brackish water, and no doubt climate, that is having the heavy rainfall as well as the low temperature, is directly responsible for development of that disease. Thank you very much.